Hi, my name is Bonnie Jackson, and I'm a Supervisory Grants Management Specialist with the Eunice Kennedy Shriver National Institute of Child Health and Human Development, and today I will be presenting on budget preparation. The overview would be consisting of budget considerations, the budget section and the FOAs, which is known as the Funding Opportunity Announcements, the direct costs, the F&A costs, which are the facility and administrative costs, and the budget components aspects. Process for preparing a budget. You'll want to know how it can be requested, how much can be requested, the F&A costs, any restrictions on what can be requested, the type of application that should be used, how to submit it, and what format to use. The FOA would include information about the types of institutions that are eligible to apply, includes information about the allowable budget for the applications. Foreign applicant organizations should consult the Section 3 of the FOA to ensure eligibility. And this is a snapshot of the funding opportunity announcement. Part 1 is an overview of the information. It includes the participating organization, which as you can see is the NIH in this case. The components of the participating organizations, which can range from a number of one up to all. In this case, we're number 4 or 5 down, the NICHD. The funding opportunity title, which in this case is an R03, it's HIV, AIDS, and it's for R03 mechanisms. The activity code, which is a small grant program. It will provide information on the announcement type. This case it's new, sometimes it's a recompete or renewal. Related notices, if any, will be reflected here. The funding opportunity announcement number, and it's reflected there. This is a snapshot of the awarded budget. And so this is Section 2, and it talks about the award, specific award information. Specifically, it tells the funding instrument, which is a grant, the application types, and again, it talks about whether or not it's a new, a resubmission, or a revision. The funds available for the anticipated number of awards, they would cover the number of grants, and it would tell you how many are being awarded, and whether or not it's a sufficient number of meritorious applications. The next section is the awarded budget, and this is particularly important. And in this case, R03s are for 2 years, and so you would submit, you would note that it's a 2-year project period, that it's a total of $100,000, and that there it cannot exceed $50,000 in any single year. The next section is the award project period, and it will tell you, again, that it's a maximum of 2 years for the total application and the total budget and award if issued. This is the section on the foreign eligibility, and this is where you would want to check to see whether or not an institution is eligible to apply. And in this case, it also reflects the type of institution, which is higher education institutions. You can have public, state, you can have for-profit if this RFA pertains to that, and also private institutions. This is a section where you would check your eligibility status and whether or not you're a foreign institution, how you would apply, whether it be a domestic with a foreign component or a direct foreign entity. These are the allowable costs. This is a section where it would tell you what types of costs are incurred by a grant recipient. The one thing that you want to check for is whether or not the costs are reasonable. For example, you wouldn't order something that wouldn't be direct benefit of the grant. Those types of costs definitely wouldn't be allowed, and if they were to be requested, they would be removed and disallowed. You want to check to see if they're allocable, make sure that they're allocable, and you want to make sure that they're in conformance with the limitations or exclusions set forth in the federal cost principles. You want to also make sure that they're consistent with the regulations, policies, and procedures. You want to make sure that they're accorded consistent with, there's consistent treatment on all of them, and whether or not it's a direct or indirect cost. You want to determine if it's in accordance with the generally accepted accounting principles, and whether or not to include any costs in any other federally supported award, unless specifically noted, authorized by statute. For additional information on this, you can confer with the cost considerations and the cost principles. This is a snapshot on the OER, the Office of Extramural Research homepage. I've also provided you with a link. This page contains a lot of pertinent information for any prospective institution that's interested in applying for an award to the National Institutes of Health. It specifically has information on how to submit an application. It has information specific with foreign grantee institutions. There were a lot of changes made this fiscal year 13, in terms of how foreign grantees are paid. They're now paid through the payment management system versus receiving a check in the mail. It's important to note that all requests for funds and financial reports must be stated in U.S. dollars. Once an award is made, the NIH will not compensate for any increases, so what's issued at the time of the award will be all that you can get, regardless of fluctuations that may cause your costs to increase. And also, it's important that all communications with NIH must be communicated in English. This is a snapshot of the cost principles, and cost principles basically tell you what you can and cannot request. So you'll want to review this section to ensure that all the costs that you're requesting are appropriate and should be reflected in or requested in your budget. Allowable and unallowable costs. Those are costs that are generally allowable under grants to domestic organizations and also allowable to foreign institutions, with the following exceptions of major and minor alterations and renovations. And there are your dollar thresholds. Your major ANR would be greater than $500,000. Your minor ANR would be less or equal to $500,000, and those are your thresholds. You would have your customs and import duties as well as patient care costs. These are not allowable on grants. Direct costs, and this is the crux of the application. These are where the majority of your costs will be reflected and or requested. So direct costs. These are costs that can be specifically identified with any particular project, program, or activity that can be directly assigned to such activities related and are easily identified, and they have a high degree of accuracy. Some of the direct costs that are included but are not limited to are such things as travel, salaries, travel, equipment, and supplies. They all have to have a direct benefit to the grant-supported activity or project. This section covers the indirect and F&A costs, which again are the facilities and administrative costs. These costs are basically the costs that the grantee organization would receive for such things as lights and things like that. And they're not readily identified with the individual project or PRAM. It serves a bigger picture for the institution. And so facility operations and maintenance costs, depreciation, and administrative expenses are examples of costs that are usually reflected under F&A costs. The organization is responsible for presenting costs consistently and must not include costs associated with its F&A rate as a direct cost, such as secretarial costs. and local phone calls. Those types of things are generally covered under the FNA pool, and so you wouldn't want to reflect those types of things under a direct cost because they're covered under the FNA. The indirect costs also for foreign grantees are 8%, except with the American University of Beirut and the World Health Organization and international organizations. So if you try to request more than 8%, we will always reduce it to 8%. So it's best to keep it at 8%. So these are just some of the budget components. The first would be personnel. And you'll see the name, the role of the project, the appointment type, the months devoted to the project, and it can be reflected as calendar months, academic months, or summer months. The salary requested for the work that's being done on the grant, fringe benefits, and then your overall totals. Some other costs would be consultant costs, equipment, supplies, other costs, expenses, and these are types of costs that wouldn't be under any other category. So that's why it's called other costs, and that's where it would be reflected. So, and then you would have your direct cost total for the overall, for each category. You just add it all up and you get a grand total. The budget narrative is basically explaining how and why you need your costs, and you basically want to make sure that those costs all agree with the costs that are being requested on the budget page. On many occasions, we'll see costs on the budget page, but when we go through and review the budget justification and we add those costs up, there's an inconsistency, and we'll sometimes have to come back to you to get additional clarification and or a revised budget. And also, it'll explain how the costs are estimated, and it'll justify the basic need for the cost. So I'm going to show you some sample budget forms, and right now we're basically working with the SF-424s. So this is a copy illustration, and this is the first section, and it's Section A and Section B. Section A covers the PI, the names of the prospective key personnel, your program your principal investigator, your co-PIs, and any other individual that's working on the grant that has a key role in this project or on this project. The Section B covers non-key personnel, so these would be your postdoc, your grad assistants, your research assistants, your tech people, and so forth. And you would just follow the column and add, you know, and enter all the information that's required. And please don't leave it incomplete, because that'll slow down the process of our review, and we'll have to come back and get additional clarification for that. Section C covers the equipment. And so the thing that you would want to put here and keep in mind is that equipment is defined as any piece of item of equipment costing in excess of $5,000. And so this is where that would be reflected. The Section D is your travel. And so you have your domestic and your foreign travel. And so you would put it on whatever line item is appropriate. Section E are your participant trainee support costs, and we don't have this. This normally is for your training grants, so basically this section is usually left blank. This section talks about is Section F, and it talks about your other direct costs. And this is where you would put things like publications, supplies, consultant, consortiums, and they're listed here in order. And if nothing meets any of these criteria, then you would just put it under these blank lines 8 through 10. And you can also add additional lines. So you may not always have a category that will cover what it is that you think you need to explain. So that's where you would put it. And then Section G would just be the total of A through F. And that's where you would put it under, as it says, A through F here. Section H covers the indirect costs, which are also your F&A costs. And so you would provide the information here. Basically, you would put the rate in on that's in effect at the time of the submission of the application. You would calculate your base. If there's any exclusions, you would put your modify your base, and you would put your the amount of the base in the middle section, which is the indirect cost base. So you would want to exclude anything like equipment that's greater than $5,000. You would want to exclude anything else that might be like tuition or something like that. You may never have any exclusion. In that case, the F&A base would be the same thing as your total direct costs. And then finally, you would calculate the funds, and you would put the funds requested based, and you would time the base times the rate, and you would get your total amount of indirect costs to be provided. And then the fee doesn't really apply to awards. And then you would have your budget justification, and you would upload that as an attachment. So if you need help, an administrative or budgetary matter, you would contact the assigned grants management specialist that's assigned on the award, and that's reflected on the award, or you can check the ERA Commons, and usually it'll be reflected as well. If it's of a scientific or programmatic nature, you would contact the assigned programmatic official. And that's also located on the notice of award, as well as in the ERA Commons. And I'd just like to thank you for your time, and it's been a pleasure to present to you today. Thank you.